Looks like it's time to pick more yellow pear tomatoes. These yellow pears are absolutely beautiful. See how they just glowing in the sunlight? Wow, there's so many to pick. If you think that's something, look at this. Look at the ones I've already picked off the other ones. That many. So now I'm going to pick these. And, you know, between this whole plant, I've just got a whole bunch of them. I don't know what to do with the yellow pear tomatoes. They're real mild, so there's not a lot of, like, heavy-duty tomato flavor in them. So I don't know what to do with them. I'm going to bag them up and go give them to some neighbors because I have just so many of these. They're just like you pop them in your mouth and they're delicious. They're delicious and they don't have that tomato-y, acid-y stuff that stays with you forever. It's the perfect, it's just real mild in flavor. Just so good. I don't know why I have my glove on, except they're like reaching in here. Anyway, this is a little update on my yellow pear tomatoes. Now, my friend Carol, who's a very smart master gardener, says that once it gets to 85 degrees, it stops setting flowers, you know. And so it makes such good sense to me. I never thought of it like that. But sure enough, there are no more flowers. And last week, it hit like about 90-something. And so that was the end of the flower production. And with that said, I think I'm going to take what's left of these tomatoes off of here and take these out and plant some corn in here. That's what I'm going to do, but I'll be leaving these. I believe these are beefsteak tomatoes, and they've got quite a bit of big ones on here. Lots of big ones. Lots of big ones. So I'm going to get back to my picking now. Pick, 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 pick those yellow pears. Yep, yellow pear tomatoes, so pretty.